Okay, so now let's look at a particular case where we're going to look at the efficiency effects of a negative externality. So going back to our good old supply and demand diagram, price, quantity, see, we have a demand curve here, supply curve here. Remember that ordinarily the supply curve comes from marginal private cost. But we know that if we have a negative externality, then let's suppose it's 2 squares high. That's the amount here of the marginal external cost per unit. And we're assuming for now this is constant, so that the harm associated with pollution is same for the first unit of pollution as it is with the 100th unit of pollution. So each unit of pollution does equal harm. In that case, the total costs, the all-inclusive cost, the true cost of production, is here, and this would be the marginal social costs equal to the marginal private cost plus the marginal external cost. So here's our market equilibrium if we have an unregulated market. That's not a quantity, that's a price. And over here we have the quantity. And what can we say about efficiency? Well, let's think about this unit right here. This unit that's produced right here is worth this amount to the buyers. And it creates this amount of total costs. So this is the marginal benefit. Should have an E in it. And up here is going to be our marginal social cost. So producing this unit out here actually is a value-destroying situation, because the total costs of production are up above the value that the consumer places on the good. So that's going to be true for all of these units that are produced in the market equilibrium. They're all going to have total costs of production greater than buyer value. So we're going to have some deadweight loss. This red shaded triangle here is the amount of deadweight loss, because that's all the units where the total costs of production are greater than someone's willingness to pay. So one, the market equilibrium, we could say the unregulated market equilibrium, is inefficient when there is a negative externality. And in particular, the efficient quantity is where this marginal social cost line crosses the demand curve. So we'll call that Q1, and we'll call this QE, the efficient quantity. So notice the efficient quantity is less than Q1, our market quantity. So the market overproduces the good that causes the negative externality. Do notice, though, that the efficient level of production is not zero. It's not that just because a good has some negative externality associated with it that it's efficient to not produce it at all. So what we need to do is, if we want to have an efficient situation, we want producers or sellers to take the external costs into account. Because if they take the external costs into account, then they'll think a little bit more carefully about how much they produce, and we will discourage them somewhat from producing so much. So it turns out that the way to do this, one of the best ways to do this, if we have a sort of constant marginal external cost, is to impose what we call a Pigouvian tax. Because all this stuff with externalities and so on and so forth, people have realized all this stuff since basically the 1920s. Economists have been able to analyze these environmental issues since at least then. Maybe no one was listening, but it was available as a way to look at it. And the first guy to analyze all this stuff was a guy named Pigou. So the Pigouvian tax, if the tax is equal to the marginal external cost, then we raise each seller's costs by the amount of the tax, and this over here is our supply curve with tax equal to our marginal external cost. So we're able to get to our efficient outcome. And sort of notice bonus here. One, this is a tax that increases economic efficiency. And notice that even if the tax revenue were just absolutely thrown down a rat hole and nothing was done with it, just the fact that we're imposing a tax increases economic penalty. We could go out there and, you know, spank people for engaging in pollution, and that would give the necessary deterrent. And even though it wouldn't create any gains for anyone else out there. So just the fact that it deters some of the production causes this tax to increase economic efficiency. The other thing is, of course, we're going to get some tax revenue. Just like before, our tax revenue is going to be, the amount of the transaction in the equilibrium times the amount of the tax, so we get some tax revenue. And the nice thing that we could do with that tax revenue is we can use that, it can be to lower other taxes that have deadweight loss associated with them. So if we go out there and we tax pollution, then we can go ahead and cut taxes on labor, like Social Security, or cut taxes on income or saving or something else that is actually a productive economic activity. And it's pretty clear, and economists are pretty universally agreed, that, you know, that is a way to go ahead and increase economic efficiency.